Oh, watch where you're going, son.
Louis, listen to me. Listen to me.
I presume this is your lab?
Yeah. Louis, listen to me. It's going to be all right, I promise.
I don't want to go.
I know it's hard, but we've gone too through Rick, haven't we? Okay, we could want to stay.
Is everything okay?
Rob!
Give it to me!
No!
You've not set it up properly.
No, Emmy, don't. No.
Dad, you've ruined it.
Yeah, sorry about that. You know what they're like with a new toy.
It's not a toy.
Let me have a go.
Oi!
Come on.
Why did you have to turn the autofocus off?
Who were they?
I don't know.
Dad, Jack's being irritating.
So, you got on one then.
Huh?
Do I want to know how much that has set me back?
No.
Where did he go?
He was upset. He's here now.
Don't you know how hard this is for me?
Come on, Louis, come on.
Hi. My name's Sergeant Hollins. My colleague who was dealing with you before, unfortunately, has had to go home early, so I'm going to do the paperwork with you. Ah. We meet again. On the high street yesterday.
I didn't know you were a copper.
No, well, they don't tattoo it to our foreheads anymore. You look like you were having a hard time. Anyway, I just need to get some details. What's your name, please?
Sean Peters.
And your address?
What do you need it for?
So we can find you again.
65 Lexington Gardens.
And have you been made aware that you were arrested on suspicion of shoplifting?
Do I need a lawyer?
No, not at the moment, but you will do when we interview you. And we will interview you because the store are going to press charges. You were caught on tape.
I buried my son yesterday.
Right. I'm sorry to hear that.
He's only 14 years old. I wasn't in my right mind when I went into that shop this morning. Surely you can make allowances for that.
Unfortunately, that's not up to me. That's for the courts to decide. At the moment, I'm just following the rules and procedures. You okay to go on? Come in. Thanks, Pete.
What's that?
It's your record.
I haven't got one.
No. Does your husband have one?
Why?
Because it says here that you made a complaint against him in the past.
And withdrew it?
Yeah, so you did.
It was just a misunderstanding.
Have you had any misunderstandings recently?
Our son died. What do you think?
Chan, is there anything you want to tell me?
No. I just want to get out of here.
Jack, any idea where your mother is?
Can I have your signature?
What's this?
Petition to free George Lake.
Why have you got it?
His son's in my maths class.
George Lake was a fraudster and a criminal.
We have a tradition in this country. Innocent until proven guilty.
He was proven guilty.
The jury is biased.
I forbid you to get involved with it.
It's a free country.
Where have you been?
I'd like to get some artichokes, but didn't have any.
When have we ever had any artichokes?
I'm practicing this meal so it's perfect for tomorrow night.
You don't have to do fancy stuff. I'm sure they eat like normal people.
The dentists. They're not normal people.
Have we seen what Van Gogh's up to here?
Oh, leave her alone. Alice at work says that this is a key age for creativity. And her son has just got a place with the National Youth Orchestra.
Don't encourage her. She might want to make a career out of it.
As long as she's happy, it's fine.
Stupid thing. It keeps disconnecting.
Listen, I better get off.
Hey, no, it's nearly ready.
I'll get a sandwich at the canteen.
I'm not having my husband going to work without a decent meal inside him. Anyway, where are the criminals going to go if you're 10 minutes late?
That's not really how it works.
Stupid thing.
Oi!
Dad, can I borrow a hammer?
This tastes disgusting. I go out to work all day. Is it so much to ask for you to knock me up something decent for when I get back?
I thought you liked sausages.
Oh, I do. But I don't know what this slop is.
Can I finish mine upstairs?
Yeah, go on.
No, you can eat your dinner down here with us. You're not councillor steak trash.
I got a card from my sister. Said she's thinking of us.
So?
I wanted her there on Monday.
Yeah, we're not talking about that.
Finish.
Go on, go to your room.
Oi, I didn't say you could go.
Go!
You think that's any way to speak to my son?
He's my son too. It's the only one I've got left.
You better watch your mouth.
Sorry.
You're saying this is all my fault?
No.
I love that kid.
You think I didn't? I can't take it, Tom.
I lost my son thanks to you.
We killed him.
You're going to pay for what you did. You know that, don't you?
Disturbance reported, 65 Lexington Gardens. Any car in the vicinity? Please respond.
7244 to control. Yeah, we're only a few minutes away. We'll take it.
How do you like one?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, one of your neighbours has reported a disturbance.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, raised voices, that kind of thing.
So?
Well, so we thought we'd come and check that everything was OK.
Everything's fine.
Good. Do you mind if we come in for a minute?
What?
Who else is in the house, sir?
My wife, my son.
Have you been arguing?
The wife's upset. We buried our eldest son on Monday.
Sorry to hear that.
It was all a stupid accident. So I'm really sorry if our neighbours were annoyed by some loud voices, but we've got bigger things to worry about.
Yeah, of course you have. Can I have a word with your wife, please? Is that a problem?
She's asleep.
I would still like to speak to her.
Yeah, well, she's exhausted, what with everything going on.
Yeah, I understand. But I'll only be a minute.
Okay. She's up here. You awake, love?
She all right?
Oh, she's dead to the world. Told her not to come in here. Only upsets her. She's been taking these. She's got them on a prescription from Dr. Maguire down at the Riverside Surgery. She takes them when She thinks things are getting on top of her. They'll wear off eventually. I'll let her know you're here. Right, son. That's all right. It's Louis. It's been pretty tough on him.
Must have been. Okay, then, I'll leave you in peace, thanks. And if there's anything I can do, anything at all, you know where to find me.
I'm sure we'll be fine.
What on earth do you think you're playing at?
Just calm down.
Showing up at my house like that, trying to cause trouble. Tom didn't know I'd been nicked the other day.
Your neighbours heard you arguing. They called us out.
And you didn't recognise my address?
Why don't you sit down?
Why don't you keep your nose out of my business?
Because I think deep down, you want to ask for help.
Oh, really?
Yeah, really. I've seen the footage from the shop the other day. A blind man could have spotted you shoplifting. I think you wanted to get caught.
Don't be stupid.
You see, I'm guessing that you've wanted to talk to us for quite a while. Otherwise, why are you here? Has he hurt you? Look, Chan, I'm trying to help you. And my experience tells me that he's a dangerous man. I saw into the living room and I saw what was on the table. But I can't prove any of that, which is why I need your help. It's as simple as that. So I'm going to ask you again. Has he hurt you?
Yeah. Not since Rick. He likes to play games first.
Right, well, you can't stay there anymore.
I've got nowhere else to go.
We have shelters.
I've been to your shelters. Do you know how long it took him to find me last time? 36 hours. I barely had time to unpack.
What if it was different this time?
Tom's got mates who work at this station.
What?
He'll probably thump my teeth out just for talking to you now.
Do you know who those mates are?
No. But I don't trust your people.
Right, well, I can assure you that I am not one of his mates. And you can't trust me. Look, what if there was another way around this man? I could find you somewhere where he couldn't reach you.
How?
Because I've got friends in other forces. Not the other end of the world, but far enough away. If they admit you, then no one here at the station would have access to your case.
I can't. He'll kill me. I need to weather the storm just for Louis's sake.
Your other son, Rick?
Yeah.
Forgive me for asking this. How did he die? Your husband said it was an accident. I have read the coroner's report.
He used pills. Easy enough to get hold of, I suppose. There's plenty of stuff lying about the house. How could he even know about something like that at his age? It doesn't make sense. I don't understand why he'd do that just to get away from him. From us.
Listen, I am genuinely sorry for what's happened to you. But you can't just do nothing. You've got another son who needs you.
I can't go home. He'll know I'm up to something.
You won't have to.
Where would I go while you sort things out?
I have a safe place.
I've told you, Tom's got friends here. There's nowhere safe.
Get off!
You said I could have it today.
You wanted to use the camera.
I've used the camera, now I need to use the computer to edit the photos, idiot.
Tough!
Oh, Mom!
Will you two put a sock in it? Please. Oh, hello! Oh, I wasn't sure what to wear tonight. I mean, I'm thinking this is a bit formal considering it's in our house, but...
Karen. This is Sian and Louis.
Hello.
We all met briefly on Monday. This is Jack and Emmy.
Louis, say hello.
They need somewhere to stay tonight. I said they could keep in their living room.
Right. I'm sorry we haven't got a spare room. It's the kids, you know.
Oh, this is fine. Louis can sleep on the sofa and I'm happy on the floor.
Sure.
I'm just so grateful to Sergeant Hollins for helping us.
Yeah, good old Sergeant Hollins is one in a million.
So, what are you into?
Does he speak English?
Of course he speaks English. We're in England, stupid.
Come on, Louis. You don't need to be shy. You can trust these people.
Right. Well, I need to pop back into work. Unfinished business.
Not a problem. I'll see you out, sweetheart. Play nicely.
What do you think you're playing at?
I know. I know you had the dentist coming round tonight, but it was an emergency.
Can't have people round for dinner. We've got squatters in the living room. Oh, how important this was to me. I want to get in there before they advertise the job.
We can do it another night. It's not the end of the world if your dentist come round for dinner next week.
Who are these people? You didn't know who they were on Monday.
I didn't.
Look, about bringing your work home, this is ridiculous.
They're harmless.
And what about the people they're hiding from? Are they harmless as well?
I never said they were hiding.
I'm not stupid. That woman's in trouble. Tell me this. Are our kids in danger because they're here? It hasn't even crossed your mind, has it?
I just couldn't leave them. They needed help.
Oh, and only Rob Hollins can swoop in and save the day. Three cheers for...
Okay.
If our kids get hurt in any way...
They won't. I swear. Karen, you've got to trust me, okay? Please. You do trust me, don't you? Will he be wanting a lawyer? I'd recommend it. Assault's a serious charge.
You've got nothing on me.
Is that you saying you don't want a lawyer?
Did she put you up to this? Silly cow. I want to see her.
Yeah, you might want to, but it's not going to happen.
She's my wife. Where is she? No matter. I'll find her.
Not this time you won't.
Oh, she hasn't done a helpless victim act on you, has she? Only an idiot would fall for that. She made a statement against me.
Not yet.
Of course she hasn't. You've no evidence. So you can hold me for what? 48 hours tops? Tell her not to worry. I'll be home soon.
If you take a rubbish photo, it doesn't matter. You can just take another.
I wouldn't take a rubbish photo.
Everyone does.
Not me.
How do you print them out?
You can take them to the shop.
Or we could do it at home if we had a decent printer.
Dream on, kid.
Were you meant to be doing something tonight?
Oh, it doesn't matter.
Sorry, I didn't mean to mess things up for you.
No. It's just a couple of the partners coming over, the dentist.
Is that where you work?
Yeah. Well, I'm a temp at the minute, but there's a possibility of a permanent job and, you know, the kids getting older, you know, I just... chance to spread my wings.
Take one of us with Mum.
Hey, I'm not having my picture taken, thank you very much.
Come on, Jack.
Oh.
Come on.
Come here, you're a bossy little madam!
Go and have a look.
How's it look?
I want one with Mum in.
Oh, no. I haven't got my makeup on or anything.
Please.
No, come on. Say cheese!
Edam!
Cheddar!
All right, Jack, stop killing things. Let's leave our guests in peace.
We're near the end of a level.
I've heard that one before. Come on, say no night.
Night.
Anything you need, just give us a shout.
Thank you so much for all of this.
Bye. Night.
Night. All right, Louis, come on. Switch that off and let's get ready for bed, eh?
I wanted to say about the hot water. I'm so sorry. You just need to leave the tap running.
Okay.
Night. Asleep, I think. Stop moving around anyway. What happened to her?
Nothing you need worry about.
Someone hurt her?
Yeah.
Have you stopped him?
Yeah, I have.
Are you going to get into trouble for bringing them here?
Not if nobody finds out.
But if they do?
They won't.
You're not going to make a habit of this, are you? I don't have to start calling you Maverick.
No. This is a one-off. I promise.
I know you see terrible things at work, but I do not want that bringing home. I do not want my family part of that.
I just couldn't leave her.
There's a line, Rob, and you crossed it.
I know. And I'm sorry.
I am so proud of you. Don't do it again.
Come on, it's safe. He's locked up till at least tomorrow. And once we've got your statement, we'll make sure that he's locked up for a lot longer than that. Grab some stuff. And you need never come here again. Obviously, you can't take everything.
Yeah, I know. I've done this before.
But we'll make sure that he goes down. I promise. You best get going, though. Otherwise, we're going to miss the social workers.
Do you want a drink? We could play with Jack's game. Would you like that? Or you could use the camera and I promise that I won't tell Emmy. It's gonna be all right soon, kid. Will you excuse me? I just,
We're back, love. Come here. Everything okay?
Yeah.
Has he behaved?
Oh, as good as gold.
Oh, that sounds like it might be them.
I hope everything, you know.
Thanks.
Your carriage awaits.
I don't know how I can ever...
You don't have to thank us. It's all back.
Is it over?
Yeah.
The poor kid.
They should be safe now.
Promise me that we'll never do anything to hurt Jack and Emmy.
Well, we're hardly likely to.
I mean anything. That poor kid's going to be screwed up for life after what his parents have put him through.
If you're that worried about your parenting skills, maybe we should put them up for adoption. Come on.
Lunchtime. Campus is dead. Won't be anyone here for a while.
When someone clearly knows you and you cannot place them for the life of you. Nightmare.
I noticed you've got some scars there. Do you mind if I take a look?
You understand. You get this.
So would any good therapist. You're only going to jump into the set with them.
Yeah, but your heart...